Alright, so this is the third chapter, and actually in this course this is the third lesson. So we will start by making the handle, and actually I want to show you the sample. We have here the sample, and we will try to simulate this handle in this video. We will make this shape, and then we will push it, and this shape is the same thickness, which is 25 millimeter, and let's go here. So I have make the reference, which is here. We can start to draw from scratch again. We'll start another area here from 150 to, and also I want to make some shortcuts here for the ortho. So the ortho is F8. So we have F8 to be this handle, and again I will offset by 40, which is 4 centimeter, and make a line from here to here, and again offset distance of around 30, and which is here, and make line to be here, and again I will trim this line. I want to trim this line, and we don't want it anymore, and actually we don't want this line anymore, and we want to make some adjustment here. So I will draw some line here, and I will offset this line again to be 70, and I will offset here. Right, and after that, let's offset it again by 6500, and I will offset this one by 20. I will offset this one by 20 and point here, not 20. I will offset by 15, and again we want to make some arch here. So basically we have some tools for drawing the arch. Alright, so we have the start and the end and the direction. Start and end point, which is here, and this is the direction. And I think we don't want these lines anymore, and we will start to make some adjustment here, and we will make some line from here to this area, and again to this area. So then we can go to make some adjustment also here. We want to make a rectangle, and this rectangle will be starting maybe from this perpendicular, which is so I will make a rectangle. This rectangle will be some small area like this, and let's move it, and I will copy this rectangle from here to here to here, and another two copies to be in this area. We can also use the array modifier, but this and choice for you. And I will now go to the trim and trim all these areas. I will trim this, and we have also to trim again here. And trim again here. Alright, and now we don't also want this line anymore, so I will delete, and we can make a line from here to here, and using the trim we can trim all these parts. And I think we actually can go from this point to this point. And I will trim and move this line from here to be here. What we have? We can save some material by going to offset this one around maybe 5 millimeter. And this side, and I will extend, and we can trim all these parts. And we can go from here to this here. All right. And after that, I think we don't need any more. All right, let's see what we have. Again, we can save. And after that, so now we will make the circles. The circles will be as usual 4 millimeter diameter. So we are in the top, and I will make a circle. And this circle, this is the center, and the radius will be 2. And we have the circle. Then let's wait. So I will move the circle from the center to be in this axis, and I think it will be in this axis around 12, and I think we will move also in this area here. So we will move from here to here. Because we are in CAD, we can use some measurement, so we can go for 6 in 180. Right, then I will copy this one, which is in circle, and we can place here, and I will move from here to this place and move from here to this place. Alright, I think now we are done. I will go to the object and we will select, we can see that we have all our closed geometry that you can see here. So our tool is the bush. Selecting the bush and select this area, and you can go for a distance of 25, and this our first geometry. So we can go to the top and move it from here to a distance which is maybe 20, which is 2 centimeter, and move from this base point to be a distance of which is here, and what about the mirror? So finally we will make a mirror, first point here, second point will, and also from here, and you are now done for the first or the second part in our geometry. So if you want to go further to the next step, you can go for making some adjustment. So in this viewport, you can select the fillet, and I will select some this one, the radius, and this object radius 25, and select the edge. I will select this edge and select this edge and click the enter. Failure because the fillet is larger than this one. So again, I will select the object and the radius of maybe 4, and this is the edge, and click enter. And I think the edge is larger, so we will go for fillet. And let's go for fillet again. And the radius will be 4 or 3.5, and object here, and select the edge. This is the edge. If you go to the wireframe, you will see that we selected the right edge, and click the enter. And again. And this is the edge, and we are now done for the fillet. Let's go here for a large number, so we'll select also the fillet, and the radius will be 5, object here, 5, and edge, and enter. And we can also make some fillet here, but this time we want to make radius of 2, so we'll select the fillet, and this is the object, and the radius will be 2, and this is the object, radius of 2, radius of 2, and object radius, and this is the edge, and click enter. And also this one we can make fillet, and we'll select the fillet, and radius this time will be, I will start to 6 millimeter, and select this object and enter. This is an edge, and this is an edge, and this is the edge also. And click enter 2 times, so we are now done for our first geometry. Because this is don't need, I will try to remirror. So I will remirror from this line to this line. And this is the third chapter. So in the next chapter, we will make some components also that will handle and connect these two pieces.